first speaker is Jonathan Nelson. Jonathan, welcome. It's good to see you again. And you're representing a number of people who have signed your card. Would you ask all 10 of them please rise? Those who have signed their card, you'll stand up. That's close enough for government work. Okay. Please state your name, address, and proceed with your comments. You have 10 minutes.
My name is John Nelson. I live at 4500 Westridge Avenue in Fort Worth, 76116. In 2000, the city made a strong statement for inclusiveness by adding sexual orientation to its anti-discrimination ordinance. However, as with any city, there remains an underbelly, and the events of the Rainbow Lounge brought that to light. There has been much emotion. If you read the blogs on both sides, there has been a tremendous amount of name-calling on both sides. And what I'm going to say initially about how some people feel about the facts from the LGBT community is for the purpose of allowing you to know the level of emotion that exists. I wasn't going to do this, but I am. I think it's important for you to know what it's like. Many of you know me. I've been here for 30-something years. I love this city. And yet, even I am subject to demeaning caricatures. Some of you may know that I have represented and am representing a religious organization in regard to property, a property dispute in a Tarrant County courthouse. And this is an email that I received on The person who wrote that didn't have the courage to send it to me. This person decided to send this email to lawyers and professionals in this city. And this is what it said. The subject: how does John Nelson find time to sodomize his gay partner? With all of his interviewing in the gay press like the Dallas Voice, his active membership in local gay, lesbian, bi, and transsexual chamber, his proclivity for picking up rent boys at the Fort Worth Rainbow Lounge, and of course his true passion, trying to strip local churches of their houses of worship for disapproving of openly gay priests, you'd think Jonathan Nelson had superhuman abilities. Oh wait, it's all the meth and coke he puts up his nose. God bless such a hard-working butch pack. That is what it can mean to be gay in Fort Worth. And that is why I'm going to discuss some of the initial reactions from the powers that be, which caused us so much concern. The first reaction by the city's top police officer was made in a statement the evening of that Sunday. And that statement, couched as fact, related three supposed incidents where the officers were sexually accosted. And the chief of police went on to say, you're touched and advanced in certain ways by people inside the bar. That's offensive. And he went on to say, I'm happy with the restraint used when they were contacted that way. And this is the statement before any investigation was done. And from our standpoint, from reading them, it was our impression that decisions had already been made, that judgments had already been called. And although he called for an investigation, we wondered, after that statement, made as fact before any investigation,